straight game where you guys just seemingly found a way to win. I asked Dwayne some question. What goes through your mind in those situations to be able to be on the road and just kind of fight through it?
Coach preaches about us being resilient. We already knew that Pitt was going to be a tough matchup. We knew that it was going to make the game gritty, and we had to work hard. We already knew that it wasn't just going to be an easy walk on the floor and they just give up. We knew that it was going to have to come down to the end at some point. And I'm really proud of our guys in a way that we just fought all the way to the end without really playing offense as well as we wanted to.
You had a really clutch three late to kind of get you guys back within it. Didn't seem like you had any hesitation in taking it. Is that just kind of the confidence you have as a player?
Yeah, that's just me just being confident. I always said that I feel like I could be way better for my guys and my coaches, and I'm going to try to continue to prove that each day.
What was going wrong for y'all in the first 35, 37 minutes?
I just think we just missed shots. I felt like we had got a lot of good shots at points. You know, a couple times the ball went a different way. They made some tough shots off the backboard, late shot clock ones. But like I said, we didn't let that kill our spirit. We just kept playing defense, kept fighting. And at the end of the day, to hold a team like that who was very hot and feeling confident on their floor and to hold them and win the last 4 minutes and overtime scoring the last 7 points, I think that's really a testament to us.
How tough is it to keep them off the glass or you know, from getting to the rim without fouling them?
Yeah, it was real difficult. As you see, we fouled a whole lot. They got to the free throw line. They probably was in a double bonus at like 10 minutes. But, you know, that was something we really talked about for the last 10 minutes, being able to guard them, be aggressive, but not to foul at the end of the shot. And I feel like we was able to slow them down once we didn't foul that much.
You're a fifth-year senior. You were out there with a true freshman kind of late in crunch time. What did you make of David Johnson's boys out there?
I think he did great. He's going to be he's phenomenal. He's going to be a sensation that y'all going to be talking about for the next few years. He's a great player, and as you see, he's building every day and every game since he has got back.
Dwayne, another big clutch three. Mm-hmm. I mean, he's just been on point lately. It seems like late in the game. What are you seeing out of him?
Yeah, that's Dwayne's side. What can I say? That's our glue guy, our motor, and you know, he brings it every day, offensively or defensively, whatever you ask for. The past two games, teams deciding to leave him open, he has been hitting the daggers for us.
Pitt defended Jordan Warp pretty well in the first half, but what else did he do to contribute, you know, when he wasn't on the score sheet?
Yeah, he did a lot. I feel like he definitely two clutch rebounds at the end of the game that I can vividly remember. I think one before overtime, and then one in overtime that was real big for us to have. And Jordan's steady presence out there. They're going to have to guard him 24-7, and he knows that. So when his offense isn't clicking, he does other things like screen for us, get guys open, does a good job of communicating. And we need that from him because we know a lot of teams are going to be keyed on to him.
Dwayne said he wasn't aware until, I guess, I told him. But did you know Duke lost tonight?
No, I did not know that. So
what are your early impressions of them?
It's another game on the road. I mean, we know it's going to be a tough test. You know, that's ACC basketball. Every game on the road is going to be tough. And we're going to be ready to bring it. We'll get in the lab Thursday and get things right.